My name is Mark Milbauer, and I've been at Green River teaching the auto body collision repair program for 18 years. As you can see, we are a master MATEF ASE certified program. We have been for several years. Let's take a tour of the shop. All of our projects enter the main shop door here. We are a very hands-on program. Students, once they gain mastery in their preliminary skills, start practicing and working on actual customer vehicles. So we do most of our structural work in this area. On the other side of the shop here, we do most of our mechanical work. We do all of our own mechanical work in this program as we are master certified, so air conditioning, airbag diagnosis and installation, scanning for codes, brakes, suspension. We do everything here, everything associated with collision repair. Although our students are required to purchase tools, the set that they're required to purchase is fairly minimal, but it's enough to help them get employment in the industry. We have currently two full-time sections of students, a day section and a night section, each with 18 to 21 or so students. The toolboxes you see here are student toolboxes. We even have a lot of the traditional metalworking tools that you won't find in the collision repair shop. For instance, our English wheel, you can see it here, shear, brake, planishing hammer. As a matter of fact, this English wheel, we built this English wheel here, primarily in the body shop with the assistance of our machining program and one of our shop helpers. Still in the main shop, we have, again, you'll see general body work going on here. Let's move back to the paint shop. This is where most of our paint work is done. We have two spray facilities. We have a downdraft bake booth here. Over here we have a prep booth where we do priming and painting of small parts. Our paint mixing room. Just recently we upgraded to a complete water-based paint system. Base coat, clear coat. This is in an effort to be a green program and with keep the environment and ecological concerns in mind, and to also train our students in, this, in what's going to be the future of automobile painting, and that's water base. Here we have fresh air breathing masks. All of the air in our paint shop back here is grade D breathable air. So again, it's all for the safety of the students and to follow the current safety practices as far as spraying. With that, why don't we go up to the classroom and conclude our tour. One of the things that we're very pleased about in this classroom is that there, at each seat, there is a computer station with internet access. As a part of our program does involve some internet training and so forth. I've been involved with ICAR since its inception in about 1978. I started taking ICAR classes for my employers probably shortly after that, perhaps 1980. Every year I update my ICAR transcript by taking more classes. At one point I was one of the two ICAR welding certification test administrators in the state of Washington. And so I'm very familiar with ICAR. Firm believer, and of course we use all of the information I get from ICAR within our curriculum. Wherever they go, if they're going to work at a successful shop in the industry, they will be dealing with ICAR. The shops are, due to insurance reasons and so forth, need to send their technicians for ICAR training. So it's very important, one, that our students be familiar with it, they know what ICAR is, and that when they get out in the industry and they're expected to go to classes, or they go to classes because they want to go to classes, that would be my ultimate goal, I guess, is that when they leave here, they ask their employer, when can they go to an ICAR class? But more than that, ICAR to the collision repair industry is like the AMA to the medical industry. ICAR helps improve our standards. It keeps us, the repair shops, on the cutting edge of technology, helps keep us abreast of the changes in vehicle construction and the repair techniques. And while ICAR isn't about training students, they're about training practicing technicians and insurance adjusters and so forth. I do believe it's important to follow, to one, be up on all of the ICAR information and technology myself, but more important, to incorporate everything I learn at ICAR into our classes so that our students are learning the latest technology, they're familiar with ICAR, and when they get out in the shops, they're prepared to perform the type of work that is expected of them in the industry. And probably the unique thing about us is that we are so extremely hands-on.
My name is Jessica Gothier. I've received 2 scholarships since I've been here. Hands Deep involved in our car show that we held in June, Bare Steel Behind Gloss. I was active the quarter before in our pet supply drive for the King County Animal Shelter, and a few quarters before that we did an aluminum can drive for a local senior center to help them provide free lunch programs to bring the communities together. Having ICAR take care of my tuition leaves me the financial assistance money to be able to provide child care for my daughter.
That's the thing that's nice about here is it's very diverse. I mean, we have people right out of high school, and we have people that are, you know, in their mid-50s, you know, coming from all sorts of backgrounds. You know, again, just right out of school and having really no background, to people coming out of the military or coming working from Boeing, Kenworth. You know, we have people from all over.
I left college in 1975. And went into the industry, I was shocked, genuinely surprised by what was expected of me, what I was expected to know, the pace that I was expected to produce at, the quality I was expected. It was really tough. So I vowed that in my program, when my students leave here, they hopefully won't be as shocked as I was and many others were, that they'll be set up for success. And after all, they come to a college like this, a program like this, to learn to repair customer cars. So that's what we do.
My name is Leonard Vlasic. I'm actually the founder of Thoroughbred Collision Centers, and now currently the Vice President of Operations for the CURMAC organization. Green River distinguished themselves. I think they've been very innovative in their practices. They're very engaged in the future. These are advanced level technicians. I would say that there's definitely more than 10, and inside of our company, I think close to the original 6 from many years ago are still with me. Just what they've done with investment in their program there. Their involvement in improving the curriculum and aligning that curriculum to more current technologies, current technologies that are accurate and current in today's environment of physically working on the cars.